The gardener did not even introduce herself to the new au pair. She barely acknowledged her at all, simply treated her as if she'd always been there. The others in the room just assumed they'd already met, which, if she were honest, was how the au pair felt when she first saw the young woman.
All to see without my eyes, the first time that you kissed me, boundless by the time I cried.
The au pair was tired. She'd been tired for so long. She'd chosen someone to keep close to her that she could feel tired around. Chosen someone who might help her burn away the shadows.
Sometimes, someone like this moonflower just might be worth the effort.
The au pair could not remember the last time she'd slept this well, and she thought perhaps she never had.
Good night. Just good night. There were other nights, and there will be other nights.
You promise?
Days turned to months, the months to more. And before the au pair knew it, a year had passed. A trip around the sun.
Is that a moonflower?
Yeah. I'm not sick of you. At all. I'm actually pretty in love with you, it turns out.
One year became two. And from two, it spread into an endless time. So it seemed. Three, four, 5 years would pass. There was peace.
Danny, why is there...
Here's the thing. You're my best friend. And all my life. And I don't know how much time we have left. But however much it is, I'm gonna spend it with you. And I know we can't technically get married, but I also don't really care. We can wear the rings and we'll know. Okay? And that's enough for me. If it's enough for you,
I reckon that's enough for me.